We have some breaking inputs coming in. Rahul Gandhi has upped the ante against the Bharatiya Janata Party. And Rahul Gandhi is leveling some sensational allegations. Rahul says Prime Minister helped Prajwal escape. Rahul Gandhi further said Prime Minister is seeking votes for mass rapist.
Prajwal Ravanna 400 महिलाओं का रेप करता है, वीडियो बनाता है. ये सेक्स स्कैंडल नहीं है, इसको मैस रेप कहा जाता है. और स्टेज में कर्नाटका के सामने प्रधानमंत्री मैस रेपिस्ट का समर्थन कर रहे हैं. वो कर्नाटका को कह रहे हैं कि अगर आपने इस रेपिस्ट को वोट दिया तो मेरी मदद होगी. कि जब प्रधानमंत्री आपसे वोट मांग रहे थे तो उनको मालूम था प्रज्वल रवन्ना ने क्या किया था. मोदी जी की गारंटी, मैस रेपिस्ट को वो हिंदुस्तान से भागने देंगे. 400 महिलाओं का रेप किया, तब भी प्रधानमंत्री जी ने उसको जर्मनी जाने से नहीं रोका.
Deepak is joining us with more details. Deepak, Rahul Gandhi leveling sensational allegations, says you had the machinery, the intelligence, and still Prajwal Ravanna was allowed to escape, flee to Germany. That's the allegation.
Well, Swati, as far as politics and politicians commenting on this case is concerned, it's continued unabated. The Congress has been saying that the BJP allowed him to escape. The BJP has been saying, the Congress didn't do anything about the case. They sat on it for about 10 days. In fact, they had details about it a year before. Now, Mr. Rahul Gandhi, of course, who's campaigning now in Karnataka, is once again saying that the Prime Minister campaigned for him and, they are the ones who are shielding him. Of course, at this point in time, the SIT continues its probe. A second woman has come out and filed a complaint. This is something that the Home Minister himself has confirmed. A lookout notice has been issued to the airports and ports as well, seeking information about Prajwal and his movements. His father, H.T. Ravanna, who is also accused number one in the first FIR that has been registered, is expected to appear before the CID, and the Home Minister himself has said, failing which, there would be consequences, including that of arrest. So right now, everything around this case, of course, is at a boiling point. When will Mr. Prajwal Ravanna arrive? As far as his latest post on social media, it says after 7 days. That would mean after the 7th of May. And that is the day, of course, the third phase of the elections is going to take place, and Karnataka, especially northern Karnataka, the 14th seats there will be voting. So this is, of course, a huge development. Rahul Gandhi, of course, launching a fresh salvo on the BJP and the Prime Minister. Now, there are multiple questions, of course, that do come up. On one hand, of course, that while there has been a blame game of who didn't act as far as Mr. Ravanna leaving the state and going to another country is concerned, the question here is, he left on the 27th during the wee hours. The FIR was registered only later in the day, and the SIT was formed even more later. So if there was no FIR against him, does that stop any individual from leaving? Now the question is, if the state police had information about this leaked video and they knew that there was going to be some sort of action that could be initiated against him, they could have also acted or prevented him from leaving the country. So at this point in time, it looks like it's more politicking than anything else that's happening. The focus, of course, as far as SIT is concerned, also remains on speaking to as many victims, trying to get their statements, because at the end of it, this is a case of sexual abuse, sexual assault, which needs to be probed from that angle. If there are any victims in this particular case, women who are exploited, they need to be contacted. They need to be given the courage to ensure that they come out, because this is a very influential person that we're speaking about.